Hello everyone, this is Dr. Carolyn Maria, working as an assistant professor in Loyola College of Education, Chennai. The title of the course is Childhood and Growing Up, which comes under Course 1. We are going to deal with Unit 1, Growth and Development of Childhood. This is Part 2 video lecture, which is going to focus on the factors influencing growth and development, impact of nature and nurture on child development. This video lecture is planned in such a way that the learner will be able to identify the factors influencing growth and development, gain thorough knowledge about nature and nurture. Let's first focus on what are the factors which influence growth and development. We have seen already what is growth and what is development in my Part 1 video lecture. Just a recap. Growth is the height and weight of a person, which is measurable, which is quantitative. Development is skill oriented and which is not easily measurable, rather it is observable, and it is both qualitative as well as even quantitative. The factors which influence this growth and development could be equally divided into internal factors and external factors. Internal factors are the heredity. Whatever a child begets from the parent, the inherited traits, that is what called as heredity. The biological factors, whatever the child gets from parent. For example, if the parent are tall, you can expect the child also to become tall, to grow tall. And same way, in opposite, vice versa, the parent are short, obviously the child also may become short. So this is what the heredity and intelligence. In relation to the emotional factors as well as the social nature, whatever the nature or the temperament the parent have, obviously the children may have all those through inherited traits. What are the external factors which affect the growth and development? First of all, environment. Environment in the womb and environment after birth. We can divide the external factor into two, within womb and outside. So within womb, what are all the food habit the mother was having, what were the medicines the mother has taken, what are the other treatments the mother have undergone, radiation, delivery complications, and physical health, mental health, all these are playing a major role with regard to the external factors of growth and development. Same way, after the birth, if a child come across with any accident or incident, or with regard to the physical, environmental and medical care which is provided to the child, and the culture as well as whatever exposure is provided to the child, accordingly the child's growth and development will get affected. If a child come across with any accident or incident, if a child gets a scar in the body, that will be there till death. So that is how the growth and development are affected by the external factors. What are the basic factors of development? Heredity and environment. I told you already, heredity is whatever the traits, physical and emotional as well as psychological traits, what we inherit from our parent is what called as heredity. Environment is everything around the child. So heredity is referred to nature and environment is referred to nurture. So human being is a complete product of both heredity and environment. Let's see what is heredity. Everything the child begets biologically from the parent belongs to heredity. The traits could be divided into two categories as physical traits and mental traits. Physical traits, for example, color of the eyeball, hair texture, either wavy hair, curly hair or straight hair, skin tone, fair skin or wheatish complexion or dark skin, and body constitution, lean, fat, all this. So whatever, these are the traits the children get from their parent. However their parent look, children also may become like that. Then the mental traits. with regard to temperament, intelligence, etc. If the parent are short-tempered or if the parent are emotionally disturbed many of the times, we can see the same sort of emotional disturbance in the children also. And same way, if the parent were very sensitive, we can expect the children also may be very sensitive. So these are the trait which we get from the parent. Let's see why a child resembles their parent. Children are resembling the parent because they inherit the trait and characteristics from the parent through chromosomes. Each and every human being are provided with 23 pairs of chromosomes, and each chromosome is provided with 20,000 to 42,000 of genes, and genes are the basic units which will transfer the trait from the parent to the children. So males have XY chromosome and females have XXX chromosome. So this gender is determined by this chromosomes only. You have come across with twins in your life, I hope so. There are two kinds of twins, identical twins and fraternal twins. Fraternal twins are the twins when two ova are getting fertilized simultaneously. So they need not be of same gender. You can see in this picture two different children. One may be male or another may be female. So two eggs at a time getting fertilized to two sperms is what called as fraternal twins. But two individuals develop from one single fertilized egg is called as identical twins, or they are even otherwise called as co-twins. They would be of the same gender. Both may be girls or both may be boys, and they would be having the same placenta. But here for fraternal twins, separate placenta would be there. You could see this blood relationship between the children and their other people. See, with unrelated persons, your IQ level and height, or the similarity between your height and IQ level would be 0%. With your first cousins, you may resemble 12%. With your uncle, aunt, nephew and niece, 25% of similarity in height and IQ you may have. With your grandparent, 50%. With your parent, 50%. With your siblings, 50%. With fraternal twins, 50%. But identical twins will resemble 90% of height as well as IQ. That is intelligent quotient. Both of them would be as it is. They would be exactly resembling each other. Some people say that heredity is very important with regard to the growth and development of an individual. Some of the other psychologists say that no, environment plays a major role in growth and development of every individual. These are some supportive theories which establishes that heredity plays a major role with regard to the growth and development of individual. For example, Galton, a person who studied 977 genius people from 800 British family. He took 977 genius people from 800 British families, and he found that 537 were eminent because they were genius because of their relationship. Then he has taken 977 average men, and from there also he found that four eminent relatives were there. Then he has told that heredity plays a major role in the growth and development of every individual. H.S. Goddard studied Kallikak family. There what happened, a soldier married two women. Among the two women, one woman was a feeble-minded woman and the other woman was a normal woman. So the descendants, direct descendants of this feeble-minded woman, around 480 direct descendants were tested, and it was found that only 48 were normal. All the others were resembling the mother in feeble-mindedness. So here also he supports that heredity plays a major role in growth and development of an individual. Another study, Juk family study, where 1200 descendants of corrupted fisherman and corrupt fisherwife was studied. And in that study, they came to a conclusion that only few were normal, all others were corrupted. A fisherman, corrupt fisherman and corrupt fisherman's wife, both they have given birth to so many children and most of them were corrupted only. So all these studies have proven that heredity plays a major role in the growth and development of every individual. So how far is the impact of nature on development? With regard to your height, weight, color of the eyeball, pigmentation of the skin, hair loss with regard to men and hair texture with regard to men and women, life expectancy, vulnerability to some specific illness like diabetes or even hypertension, or even sometimes even people are saying cancer is also heredity. All these are positively correlated between genetically related individuals. If your parent are having all this, ultimately there are more chances for the offspring or the children to get all this. And individual differences are due to the person's each and every unique genetic code. So it is not 100% mandatory or general principle or 100% law that or proven fact that whatever the parent are having illness or with regard to all these inherited traits, the children may 100% would have. There are chances, there are more possibilities if the parent are having, the children also may have. So that is the law of nature. Let's move on to environment. What is environment? Environment is not just the mere physical objects like, sun, moon, water, air, land or trees or something like that. But it is related to the stimuli. Whatever the stimuli a child gets in a lifetime, right from birth till death, is what called as environment. There are few people who support that environment plays a major role in the development of children. Let's see one case study. This is a case history of a feral children. Feral children are the children who were brought up in a non-human environment accidentally. Two children called Amala and Kamala, Amala was 2 years and Kamala was 9 years. They were recovered from a den of wolf from Bengal forest. We didn't know that how they have gone there, but they were used to walk, eat like wolves. And because they were found to be in wolf den, they were just doing all the activities, whatever the wolf were doing. They were not behaving like human beings. So after then what happened, they were rescued and treatment was given for both people, but Amala died. Amala was the smaller one who was 2 years old. She cannot adapt to the new changes. But Kamala struggled a lot. After then, she learned to walk, speak like other human beings. So here what happens, even though they were born as human beings, because they were brought up in the wolf's den, they were resembling in all the activities as wolf. So here, environment plays a major role with regard to the development of a child. So the brain's plasticity and the child's predisposition to learn are shaped in the environmental influences and stimulation of physical, emotional, social, cultural, cognitive nature is increasing and it is creating a new pathway in learning and development of every human being. In order to substantiate this, let's learn about John B. Watson. John B. Watson was a father of behaviorism. He has given a very famous quotation. He told that, "Give me a dozen of healthy babies, I can make any one of them as a theologian or a criminal or any other professionalism as you want, no matter whatever is their heredity." So he told, "You give me a dozen of children, whoever wanted to become according to your desire, I can just give them a proper environment in order to make them become like that. For example, from a very good, intelligent, scholarly parent, if you take a child and you can make the child or you can give an environment to the child in order to grow that particular person as a culprit or a thief, that is also possible according to John B. Watson. So he says, whichever heredity they belong to, that is okay. But through artificial environment, whatever we could provide to the person can make a person to be a good or a bad according to the desires of the person, whoever is growing the other individual. So John B. Watson, what he has done, he has taken a boy called Little Albert. He has taken this particular boy for his experiment. What he has done is, he has taken this little Albert and he has introduced this white rat to this little Albert. So whenever the small boy trying to touch the white rat, he was just ringing a bell. So that bang sound was irritating to the child. And because it is a child, it is a baby, and the baby started crying. So whenever the child come across with the white rat, this bang sound was made. So that made the child to become to develop an aversion towards this white rat. After this baby Albert grown into a adult also, whenever this person has come across with any white fur things also, fur toys also, the person got an aversion because the person's mindset was conditioned by John B. Watson. So he says that by providing them artificial environment, we can make changes in the growth and development of every individual. So what is the impact of nurture? Nurture is the environment what we provide. Nurture on development. Nurture plays a very big role in the early human development. It speeds up an individual's capacity to study and learn new things. So the environmental factors involve both physical environment, that is the nutrition, whatever we get, and social environment, that is our family, neighborhood, media, peer pressure, and all this. So our physical environment as well as social environment, both are playing a major role with regard to the development of every individual. What is the impact of nurture? Most parents encourage their kids to take part in all the extracurricular activities like music, dance, sports, swimming, yoga, karate, etc. in accordance with the child's talent as well as the interest. So the talents have been given by nature from parent and they can only be developed into skills through the hard work of nurture. So you cannot say that nature plays an important role or nurture plays an important role, because human being is a product of both nature and nurture. Both are important. So the talents you can inherit from your parent, but when you're provided with an ample opportunity, a good conducive environment, you can develop your talent through skill, through your hard work, because a practice makes a man perfect. That is possible when we are giving a very good conducive environment for a child to grow in. And when you are asked whether nature plays a major role or nurture plays a major role with regard to child development, you'll have to answer like this. Nature is responsible for the normal development of the fetus into a normal, healthy infant, but it cannot entirely develop the fetus into an intelligent or a knowledgeable or an athletic adult, okay, or even a musician, whatever field you can take. This is possible only through the exposure, that is the nurture which is provided to a person. Therefore, you can conclude saying that it would be correct to say that although nature has some degree of influence, nurture strongly influences the early human development. So when a person is born in a family where there were no sports personality and all, you can provide a very good learning sports environment to the child, and you can make that particular person as a sports person. So through nurture, we can help a person to become a better personality. What are the educational significance of this growth and development? Both teachers and parents should provide a congenial, conducive environment for the maximum growth of the children. Teachers as well as the parents should be helpful, sympathetic, as well as encouraging to the students. And parents are expected to provide balanced, nutritious diet, and teachers are expected to provide need-based curriculum and all the co-curricular activities for the students. What are the key takeaways from this video lecture? Nature and nurture play a major role in the development of every human being. Both parents and teachers should provide conducive environment for the overall development of children. Let me ask you some question. As a teacher, how will you promote all-round development among your students? And according to you, which plays a major role in child development, whether nature or nurture? Just keep reflecting on this. These are some of the books for your further reading. Thank you for listening, students. Wish you all good luck.